Thabo Skotoyi, as I was mentioned, and I have only like 3 minutes to speak about what I want to speak about. But I'd like to take the opportunity for being here for this subject. The guy called William Ellery is sharing the same vision as I, saying that it is greater to educate a child in true sense of the word and to a large extent. Because if you want to see kids in the rulers of the state, this is actually what we can do. I'm going to speak about one of the important things in life, which is schooling. So that is what I'm going to speak about. Also, putting in mind that we are receiving a gap. At just 12 years old, this is the time when I realized that I was already proactive. By that, I was already doing my own pacification during my primary school level, as well as looking after young pupils while their teachers were not there. So this is just to elaborate that for us to make the change that we want to do in life, we don't have to wait for people to tell us to do those things we want to do. I come from a household where my mom uses to say that you must remember why you are going to school and don't ever compare yourself with others. That is why people see me a bit different than other people, because I don't ever compare myself with others. I know where I'm coming from and I definitely need to know where I'm from. But then I always keep this thing in mind that where I'm going, I need to know exactly. Which almost kind of influenced my decision of focusing just on books during my primary school level, because when you say you must focus on something, you focus on something and then you forget about the other things. So while I was still doing my primary school, I only focused on books. I didn't focus on extramural activities such as sports, such as dancing. I just focused on my books so that I can pass. So that kind of influenced my other advantages of doing other things in my primary school level. Hence, I was just focusing on what I'm there for. And for me, being at school was only about reading my books. And also the other thing is, when I was having an interview with Heidi, was how did you end up being so positive and confident in your life? I thought that it's simple. You need to choose who you surround yourself. So that is what I did. The friends that I brought myself around with were the friends that I call them energizers. When you're around people, you don't need people that will make you feel depressed. You want people that will tell you about something, and then after that, they make you feel good about yourself. That is the friends that I've chosen for myself as young as 12 years old. They were always my energizers. And the other thing that I'd like to say is, you need to choose friends in organized organizations. You cannot get good friends from street corners who are smoking drugs. They'll teach you how to smoke drugs. You can't get good friends from partying in clubs. They'll teach you how to drink alcohol. So when you get in organized organizations, such as your church, your school, your community gatherings, this is where you get good people. So that is how I actually selected my own set of friends. Coming to where exactly I'm coming from a township called Khayelitsha, which I think everyone must know if you know the history of South Africa, because Khayelitsha is one of the biggest townships in South Africa, which have a lot of higher rating when it comes to crime and violence. So I'm coming from that township. I am the product of that township. But I can't say I regret coming from Khayelitsha, because it has made me realize my own potential. Because if it wasn't for Khayelitsha, chances are I wouldn't have been this person that I am. I wouldn't have been able to work with the challenges that I'm trying to solve right now, which young people are actually facing. If I grew up in, for example, in suburban areas, chances are I would be sitting inside my house and not looking at these challenges people are facing. So growing into a township makes you to know exactly the grassroots levels of what people are experiencing outside. So that is why I'm also fortunate to say that I am proud to be the product of Khayelitsha. And that is the concept that I've designed for myself, that life has five lessons. We've got your home lesson, remember, this is your family. This is how they actually teach you how to live life. And then you go outside your house to your street, which is your community. After that, you go to what we are here about today, which is schooling. This is where you learn other different values from the teacher and from the system of education. And then obviously you will end up by your career that you choose after schooling, and then your retirement. This is where we are, and this is the concept that I have designed. Talking about my schooling and also engaging to some conversations that I've had with some couple of guys, such as Mshanguli, actually mentioned that he wasn't sure of what he wanted to do while he was in high school. I actually experienced the same thing. I had two options, but I had to select one. And then the educators will tell you, no, you have to select this one because this is how your report wants, because they judge according to your report and not according to what you want as a student. So we were the chances of being exposed to different types of cater exhibitions, they were not there. And the biggest question that I had is, why did cater exhibitions have to start in grade 11 and grade 12? While I was in grade 9, I had to select what I'm going to do in grade 10. Yes. Yeah. So that would be exploring my options so that I do exactly what I wanted to do, so that I know my options were very correct. And then doing, talking about education and schooling system in South Africa, this is the research that I've conducted. 2002, about 1.2 million students enrolled to start schooling. And then 2014, last year, the school results, and they had 171,800 made it through matric. And also they passed matric. They made it through grade 12. Which means that 47% of those that are quit school in grade 10, what happened? Where did they go to those learners? That is a half of more than, half a more than a million of kids that didn't go to matric last year in 2014. One of the other things that we experience, that I also experience, is the overcrowding. It is a huge crisis right now. Each educator, according to my own research, you are supposed to have at least 25 to 27 learners in one classroom. That is at least the number that you can actually manage. But the, where I'm coming from, there are like 45 to 56 learners in one classroom. This doesn't only affect the kids themselves. It also affects the teachers. Because that is why I have to say today that I almost also failed my review because the teacher wasn't available for a period of like 3 months. And then you have to go through your own books, not having to refer to someone to assist you. This is the proof that also educators also are also affected by the fact that there are more learners in the classroom. So the failure they are experiencing is partly the reason why we have this huge dropout in school learning. Parents, or perhaps guardians, say that they are sending their children to school so that they can be safe. They don't want their kids to get involved into the community. You know the negative things of community social bills. They are sending them to school. Did you also know that school is the second most risky place to send a child? So while parents are going to work and sending their kids to school, they do not know that they are sending their kids to another risky place. What is wrong with our school? And then I'm here because I've started an organization which is an after-school care program. The organization that I've started is called MADTASC. And the reason that I've started the organization was because while I was growing up in Kailicha, I would find some of my friends coming to me, and some of my mother's, my parents' friends, they would come to me and ask about what their friends and what their kids are going through. They wouldn't communicate the challenges with their kids. They would have to ask me because I was always this type of different person from everyone else. So they trusted me more than their own kids. That is why I decided that there needs to be a platform whereby these kids are actually taught and educated around these social issues they are facing, and they cannot speak with them about them with their parents. And therefore, parents also, because this organization doesn't focus only on life skills. One of the things I do is life skills, but I also do parent-child workshops. The other thing I realized is that there are a lot of after-school care centers, but I've worked for after-school care centers, I've trained over 18 schools in Cape Town. And the one thing I realized is that we do have after-school care and working with kids. That's not enough. You can't work with kids and expect kids to change when they are going to experience the same challenges in the household. Because we tell the kids not to smoke, not to engage into unprotected sex, when that thing is happening inside the household. So the parent also needs to be informed about what the kids is being taught on, so that they can also support the kids into making different decisions and informed decisions in their lives. That is the main reason MADTASC was started. But then I don't only do that, I also do life school, and I also do math and English tutoring, as well as high school placement. We do get some different trainings. Another guy here is Usain Piwe, coming from South African Youth Leaders Network, is one of the trainers that is also training for MADTASC. Another kid to me said, my father wants to see a pass at MPA in my report. But the moment the kid starts to say, I want to do my homework, the father or the mother will say, no, you have to wash dishes. You have to do that and that. They don't give their kids the chance to do their homework while they want to see a pass in their report. So we need to inform parents that in order for them to see the result they want, they need to support their kids Hence, that is why I started this organization in order to reduce the gap in the education system.